I'm Sushmita from Miss Pink Shoes and welcome back to my channel. So today's video is something that I've been wanting to do for quite some time, and a lot of people have asked me questions about it, but I wanted to give it a little more time, gain a little more knowledge and, you know, learn more about it before sharing with you guys. So as the title suggests, today's video is going to be all about my hair coloring experience, all the frequently asked questions and how I take care of it. So before I get started with this video, I would love it if you guys could subscribe to my channel. The link is down below, and if you've already subscribed, then don't forget to hit that little bell button right next to the subscribe button so that you get notified every time I upload a video. So this video might be a little long, like my videos have been for quite some time, because there's just a lot of things that I want to cover and I don't want to miss out on any of the points. So I'm sorry if this video is too long. I will be doing this video in three parts. So the first part is going to be about my hair color experience, my story and how many times I've colored my hair. The second part is going to be about all the frequently asked questions, and the last part is going to be about how I take care of it and general tips on how you can take care of colored hair. So without any further delay, let's get started. So starting out with my hair color story, the first time I colored my hair was about 4 years back. So I just got like 4 streaks done, like at the back side of my hair, because I was just really excited to get my hair colored because I'd just gotten out of school. But my mom was a little particular. She didn't want me to go overboard with my first time. So she kind of restricted me, and I was kind of okay with it because the fact that I was getting to color my hair was like a huge deal. So I got like 4 streaks of red color right about here. If I have a picture, I'll try linking it. It's been really, you know, it's been quite some time since I colored that. So if I have a picture, I put it somewhere here so you guys can have a look. So that time it didn't really affect my hair. My red color faded to a nice light brown, which I liked. Although I was sad about it fading, but colors do fade. So yeah, it faded in like I think 4 months or 6 months, and my hair growth is really slow, so I did have that for quite some time. So after that, I got an opportunity to be a hair model for a brand. So they did like a free hair color session and I was all for it. So I went for this really bright, you know, red pink color. Again, I put the picture somewhere here. So a huge chunk of my hair from the back, right from top to bottom, was like this bright pink red, and I was obsessed with it. Like everybody knew me because of my hair color, and my teacher literally told me that I could go stand at a traffic signal because that's how bright, you know, my hair color was. So after that, again, my hair faded, the color faded, and it faded to like a nice light brown, which is something that you guys have seen. So if you go back to my older videos, the initial, you know, couple of months, I've had like a light brown hair color. That's actually my, you know, pink red hair faded to that color. So that's when my hair started to get rough. So generally my hair has a little rough texture, but after my first hair color, nothing really happened. But after the second time, since I got that much volume done, the backside of my hair did get really dry, and I didn't really know what to do about it. And honestly, I didn't care much at that point of time because it was not very bad. And yeah, it was okay. I was sort of dealing with it. So after that, you know, faded to a really light brown, I wanted to do something to my hair again because I was bored. So I got like my entire hair color to a dark brown, and I got light brown highlights. That is something that you guys have seen a lot. So in my last 3-4 months, that's the color you would have seen. And I really liked that color because it was very versatile. I could wear it with, you know, any outfit. I didn't have to be worried about. But after I got my hair color to that brown and everything, my hair started to get really rough, and that's because I colored like my entire hair, not like just highlights. So that's when I started facing, you know, roughness issues and dryness issues and all of that jazz. So I'm gonna get to how I dealt with all of that. So basically, that was my hair color experience, and right now, as you can see, it's like this really nice red color. So this style that I've gotten done is actually called balayage. It looks very similar to ombre, but I'll tell you what the difference is. So ombre is basically a light to dark shade of any color. So say you want a blue ombre, it's gonna go from dark blue to light blue, or light blue to dark blue, however you like it, and mainly towards the end. But balayage basically is, say you're picking the color red like I have, it will fade the color from your natural hair to the red. So it'll be like a really nice transition from your natural color to the color of your choice, and not like an ombre, which is going to be a little more, you know, stiff. It might not look like a major difference to some people, but to me, it did make a lot of difference, and I like this much better than an ombre would look on me. So I'm pretty happy with the way my hair looks. So now I'm gonna get to the frequently asked questions and all the myths and whether they're right or not. So the most commonly asked question is, does hair coloring cause damage? Does it cause hair fall, roughness, dandruff, etc., etc.? So yes, if you color your hair, you are causing damage to it, because you need to understand that you're putting a lot of chemicals onto your hair. It's not natural. So of course your hair is going to be damaged. You can't put like shitloads of chemicals on your hair and expect it to be normal, because it's not natural. You are doing something foreign to your hair. So of course your hair is going to get damaged. So the first thing that happens after coloring your hair is your hair gets kind of dry, like pretty dry. And especially if you already have dry hair, your hair is going to get really dry. You're just going to be like, what the hell is happening? Because you will feel a lot of dryness. Hair fall literally depends. If you generally don't have a hair fall problem, then you shouldn't have too much of an issue. There still will be a bit of hair fall. But if you existingly have weak hair, or if you lack protein in your diet, then yes, your hair will fall and you might just feel like, you know, you're going bald, but you won't. Don't worry. But yeah, you will have quite a bit of hair fall. Now when it comes to dandruff, I personally feel that dandruff is not anywhere close to hair coloring. Hair coloring does not cause dandruff, at least in my case it didn't. I do have dandruff issues, but that's for different reasons and it has nothing to do with how I color my hair. So in my opinion, hair color does not really cause dandruff, and I feel that, you know, it's totally unrelated. Now coming to the second question is, how does it cost and how do you decide what to color and all of that? So hair color basically depends upon which salon you're getting it done from, which brand the particular salon is using. So it all depends upon that. So it can start from anywhere around 700 bucks to like 5, 10, 20 grand. It really depends on what your hair length is, what the salon is using, and etc, etc. So when you're getting like streaks done, you're just going to get like 2 streaks or 4 streaks or 10 streaks, how many ever. So you usually salons charge you by, you know, per streak. So for per streak, say they charge 500, so for 2 streaks it's going to be 1000 and so on. But when you're getting like highlights done all over your hair, or when you're getting something like this done, it is going to cost you quite a bit, because it depends upon the length of your hair and the amount of color that's going to go in. So for the hair color that I got done, it costed me quite a bit. It costed me ₹7,500, which is a lot, but my hair is quite long right now for, you know, coloring, and the volume that I got done was a lot. So I have color starting from somewhere here till my ends, all over my head. So that's quite a bit of color. So yes, that's why it costed me quite a bit. But again, the amount really depends upon where you're getting it done from and all of that, and who the stylist is. Now coming to the fading properties and what kind of colors give you what kind of results. So now when you're doing shades like browns, light browns, dark browns, or shades of brown, even warm browns or cool browns, whatever brown you're doing, it's not going to fade very easily. It's going to stay onto your hair for a really long time, because those colors are easy to produce. The pigments are very, very long lasting on your hair. So when you get colors like those, even after 6 months, your hair color might look really fresh, because browns and shades of browns tend to stay for a really long time on Indian hair. When you're going to get fashion colors like reds, blues, greens, yellow, purple, whatever, it will fade pretty soon. So now when it comes to red, when you're going to take like a brownish red or a deeper red, you don't really require to, you know, bleach your hair. It is going to show, but it's not going to be like a bright red. But if you want something as bright as mine, generally salons would suggest you to bleach your hair, which, please guys, do not bleach your hair. It's like death. It is the worst thing you can do. You're really going to cause a lot of damage. So I would highly suggest, do not bleach your hair, no matter how pretty the color is. So for the color that I wanted, I didn't want to bleach, but I still wanted something bright. So what my stylist did was, she gave my hair color a wash of a light brown shade, which used to be the color of my highlight before. If you guys have seen my videos, you might have seen my light brown highlights. So basically she colored my hair to that color, and then she put the red over top. So when my red fades, I will be left back with my old light brown color, and not with like a dirty yellow blonde color, which I think looks very ugly, and I think it damages your hair a lot. But when you're gonna get colors like pinks, blues, purples, and shades like those, it is very difficult to get those colors onto Indian hair. So what salons do is that they bleach your hair first, and they turn it into like a pale blonde or a white shade. So basically your hair becomes like a blank canvas, and on top of that, the whatever color you want goes. So what happens with that is, the bright color or the color is kind of temporary. It goes off in like 10 washes or something, and you're left back with that blonde pale looking hair, and that turns into like a really rough, you know, bush, because that's a lot of chemicals onto your hair. One more question that I've been asked a lot is, how do you choose your color or everything? So of course your skin tone, your comfort level, the kind of profession you're in, things like those make a lot of difference. But I would highly recommend that when you're picking your color, don't just concentrate on how it's going to look after you color it. Just ask your stylist on how your color is going to fade after a few months or a few weeks, because that's what really matters. Because at the moment everything is gonna look pretty, they're gonna set it well, they're gonna put a lot of serum, a lot of products, and your hair is just gonna look amazing. But after you wash it a couple of times, you're gonna hate it. So make sure that you get enough knowledge and know what you're getting into before you color your hair. Because guys, I know hair is a big deal and you don't want to play around with it, and once you cause the damage, you can't easily go back. It takes a lot of effort. So please be very careful and know what you're getting into before you decide to color or, you know, do any kind of treatments to your hair. So now I'm going to talk about the top tips that I would give you guys if you have colored hair or if you're going to get your hair colored. These are the things that you must do to maintain your hair softness and the luster and everything. So honestly, right now, the kind of softness my hair has, it's never been this soft. Even before I colored my hair has never been soft. I've always had frizzy hair, rough hair, and very, you know, dull, dry looking hair. And right now, the texture that it has, it's the best it's ever been. So I did do a lot of things, a lot of effort has gone into, you know, getting it where it is. There are still times when my hair gets really rough. It's not like I always have good hair, but yeah, it's pretty much been good since, you know, I've been doing a couple of things. So I'm going to share all of that with you guys. So the first thing is that you must oil your hair. There's a catch here with colored hair. So when you oil your hair, you tend to use double the amount of shampoo that you normally do. So your color is going to fade faster. So if you oil your hair color will fade faster, but I'm okay with it because for me, the quality of my hair matters more than the color. So that's a choice that you guys will have to make, but I would highly suggest to oil your hair. The second tip that I would give you guys is that always follow your shampoo with a conditioner. Now, even if you don't have colored hair, I think a conditioner is a must. It's basically like shoe and sock. So if you're not gonna wear socks below your shoes, your feet is gonna stink, you're gonna get shoe bites, and basically your shoes and your feet are gonna be a total mess. That's how it is with hair. It's as simple as that. If you do not follow it up with a conditioner, your hair is gonna be rough, your hair is gonna be, you know, frizzy. If you're a person who's gifted with good genes, then God bless you, you're very lucky, you don't need a conditioner. And there are a lot of people who color their hair a multiple number of times, but they don't have any damage, and that's just because they're born with really good hair and they have really strong genes. But for people like me who are born with dry hair, you must use a conditioner. Even if you have oily hair, guys, you should condition, because conditioner gives specific kind of proteins to your hair, which your hair requires to stay soft and nourished. And shampoos at time do strip off your hair of its natural oil. So conditioner sort of helps in restoring that balance into your hair. So make sure that you use a conditioner after you shampoo. The third tip that I would give you guys is always use a serum or a leave-in conditioner. So the leave-in conditioner that I would recommend, especially for colored hair, is the Wella Brilliance leave-in conditioner. I've spoken about this before. So if you have normal to dry hair, this will do the trick for you. It will keep your hair soft and nourished. So if you have drier hair, or if you want, you know, a little more nourishment to be given to your hair, I would highly recommend the Argan Oil Intense Repair Serum by Happy Hair Days. Guys, ever since this came into my life, my hair has changed, and the way you see it is right now, it's all because of this serum. And honestly, I'm so confused. I don't know where I left it, and I'm just, you know, dying. I'm getting like a sort of panic attack because I can't do without it. But I'm probably gonna go tomorrow morning first thing and get it, because I cannot do a day without that serum. That serum is just pure brilliance, and for a person like me, it's the best serum ever, because it really makes my hair soft, nourishes it, and since it has argan oil, it's really good for your hair. So the last tip is something that will work only with, you know, people who have drier hair. So you can take 3 to 4 drops of argan oil and again rub it between your palms and just apply it to your ends and sleeve. And when you wake up, you'll have like really soft feeling hair. So the only catch here is make sure you don't overdo with it, otherwise your hair can look oily. So start out with 2-3 drops, and if you still think you need more, go on, put some more, and when you wake up, it's not really gonna show that you have any oil on, because all the oil will be absorbed inside. And since it's argan oil, it's very safe to use. Make sure you use pure concentrated one, don't dilute it with anything, otherwise the whole purpose will be lost. So I really hope you guys like this video, and I'm sorry if it was too long, but I really hope this helps you guys. So if you like this video, don't forget to give it a huge thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel, the link is down below, and also follow me on my Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat and Twitter. All the links are given in the bottom bar if you want more updates from my life and what I do. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I'll see you soon in my next video. Bye.